Yeah. How about this? I'm going to make you a deal. Come see me after this, and we'll nail your message. Okay? Just in the interest of everybody else, just moving on, because I have limited time. Just in the interest, I'm going to nail your message when at the end. Okay? Come see me. Please. Tourism. Destination
management services.
Okay. That's a good message. I think that's great. How can you do you get many other companies saying similar types of things?
Well, yeah. I mean, destination management for the companies basically which attract inbound business into the country.
Okay.
So people who attract inbound business are the companies which use this kind of message.
Mm.
Beside this, there are tour operators which only concentrate on the regional UAE business, which we used to do many years ago. So we used to call it your travel partner, your preferred tour operator. So those kind of messages, but they were more regional.
Sure.
They were more within the region. But once you start getting business from abroad and you would want to give them the message that we are a destination management company. So if you think about a destination, then this is the company, because we provide you services to a destination of your choice or whatever you would wish to take your MICE business to or leisure business to. This is the destination, and this is the company which provides the destination services.
Who are your main customers?
B2B.
B2B.
Overseas, B2B, tour companies, travel consolidators, wedding planners.
From all over the world?
Well, from all over the world.
Okay. What are their main issues? What are their main issues?
Well,
their
main problems? We would like to different. I don't know what their main issues, but I think we would like to stand different so that they don't get confused dealing with smaller tour operators.
I'm sorry, I'm going to interrupt. What are their issues? The people that pay you, what are their biggest problems?
To find suitable partners.
Finding suitable partners. Why?
Because even the small tour operators would sometimes send a wrong message out saying that they're destination expert or destination management consultants.
And what happens? Which they are not. What happens to your buyers when that happens? What happens to your buyers?
Well, they face failures in services and the issues, and they get bad services, then they go back, and then
and their customers
they complain
are not
the destination.
Happy.
Yes, their customers are not happy.
Okay, so you could say I sell to these kind of buyers that has this kind of issue, that is sick of working with destination management companies that do not provide them with these kind of service, or sick of having terrible customer service because they're dealing with destination management companies that are small, that are don't know what they're doing, that provide terrible service. And the outcome you provide, what main result do you provide to your customers, to the people that pay you?
Services definitely target you.
What kind of services? Forget about the services. Move it to the side.
Yeah.
Outcome, results. What kind of results do you?
Satisfaction. Provide? I mean, satisfied services.
Why are they satisfied?
Well, it's because of our experience and the infrastructure that we own, and the number of years of operation, and the manpower, knowledge.
Okay. Move that to the side. Why are they happy? They don't care about your services, the number of people. Trust me, they do not care. I run a single-person business. I have presented in front of CEOs and ministers and all sorts of stuff.
Move that price benefit also?
Not even price.
Hmm.
Why do they pay for what?
Relationship.
Also. Peace of mind? What kind of real result do you provide? What
satisfaction,
makes you
I think. Also.
Why are they satisfied? Why are they satisfied?
Good services, we give them, exceed their expectations.
They're happy.
Why are they happy? They are happy for some reason. Why are they happy? There's got to be some kind of result. Do they make more money? Okay. I'm going to do this. Do they make more money?
Yes.
Do you save them time?
Yeah.
Do you keep them in service, best destination management company, best employees, best, long, you know, we've been in business 30 years, all of that out. Nobody cares. Everybody's saying the same thing. Everyone's saying the same. This is how you differentiate. You save them money. How much money? How much money?
Yeah, what they could make on the other.
If you can justify it in your case study, yeah. You save them usually 15 to 20%, go for it.
Correct.
If you can save them time, we are the fastest, we can do this in 20% less time than any other destination management company, go for it. If you keep them in compliance, if they have ISO compliance or anything like that, go for it. That's the kind of outcome, the real outcome that you provide. Okay? I'm going to move on. I'm going to move on because I want. I have some other kind of concepts that I want to share with you guys. I hope that was helpful for one. Yeah. Okay. Thank you. So after this, I'm going to.